Most wars in history have had a turning point. The majority of them are due to a major battle or large change, but in the Vietnam War, a series of strategic attacks against the U.S. in South Vietnam made all the difference. The U.S. entered the Vietnam War in 1965, approximately 10 years after the initial start of the war. The U.S. joined forces with South Vietnam to stop the spread of communism in the North. The U.S. believed that if North Vietnam wasn't stopped, there would be a domino effect of countries slowly turning communist. The war was costly in terms of money and lives. 58,000 U.S. soldiers died, and over 300,000 were injured. Many Vietnam veterans have been diagnosed with a range of problems such as readjustment and post-traumatic stress disorder. The Viet Cong was a group of people helping to take over South Vietnam with North Vietnam, but often the two would be called Charlie. Charlie was known for setting various booby traps, including tripwire bombs, spike-filled pits, and poisonous razor-sharp spikes. Charlie used underground bunkers and tunnels to be close to the enemy, but remain unnoticed. U.S. soldiers had to search every inch of their path for traps and landmines, or else men would surely die along their journey through the dense jungle. The date is January 30th, 1968. Tonight is Tet, the Vietnamese Lunar New Year. Tet is an unofficial ceasefire for both sides so that they can celebrate without fighting. During the night, suddenly, over 100,000 cities with military presence are surprise attacked by Charlie. The U.S. Embassy in Saigon is completely taken over. This night in early 1968 will later be known as the Tet Offensive. Tet was chosen to be the night Charlie attacked because it was a day people least expected to have fighting. Anti-war protests began to be held because citizens were promised that the war would end soon, but Tet showed to everyone that the fighting was far from over. The U.S. military lost support of its people, causing a major turning point in the war for the U.S. The recent distrust of the U.S. military caused confusion and anger. These protests even turned violent when at Kent State University, police opened fire on peaceful protesters. One of the most notable events of the Tet Offensive was the Battle of Hue. The Battle of Hue showed how Charlie lost in terms of lives, but won in terms of strategically affecting the U.S. Charlie lost the lives of about 5,000 soldiers, while the U.S. only lost about 150. Charlie executed any important person in Hue, from teachers to priests. The U.S. was able to defeat the communists because they were prepared with heavy air support and artillery ready for combat. In response to the surprise attacks of the Tet Offensive, the U.S. military invaded the small town of My Lai, killing many unarmed civilians and children. My Lai was burned to the ground. This response to Tet put an even worse stain on the U.S. military. The support for the war was heavily diminished, and people started to question the importance of the U.S. military being present in Vietnam. In 1973, the U.S. withdrew from Vietnam. In 1975, South Vietnam fell to a full-scale invasion of Charlie, ending the Vietnam War.